before I start with my life, I would like to thank you for sharing your stories and kind of how to show us how, you know, kindness, it builds connections and it really has a really big impact, which is why I chose the gift of kindness as my topic, because I think not a lot of people think about kindness and how powerful its impact can be. I mean, it can be very life-changing. Kindness to show people your serenity. Can't say that word. Okay, so basically like being authentic and basically you want to help them from the very bottom of your heart. And it's something that has changed my life greatly. Like I would not be who I am today if it wasn't for the kindness that others have shown me. It was all possible because of people's kindness. And I don't know which stories I should talk about. I have so many examples. I can't even tell you my life story, but I think that will bore you guys to death, so I guess I'll spare you on that. So first of all, again, I'm Sylvia Zoe. I'm from the USA. I come from California, San Diego, and I recently graduated from San Diego State University. My graduation ceremony was supposed to be 2 days from now, so I missed it to come here because I thought this was a really great chance to kind of share my experiences, and I really want to hopefully help change other women's lives, because for me, I hope that my story will be able to touch others. So for the last 2 months, I actually managed to win 3 awards, 4 if you count the one that I actually won for one of my professors, which is really amazing. And you know, it really, like, I was speechless. My aunt was there to kind of witness the moments that, you know, I won these awards, and it was not something that I did myself. A lot of people tell me how amazing I am. You know, I'm, you know, so talented, and you know, I'm always so on task. But I tell them all the time, I remind them that, you know, how I was able to get here is all because of you guys. You guys all who supported me, who have shown me your kindness. And these 3 awards, I guess I can go into it. So it started about 2 years ago. I met this one girl, her name is Kelly Barrios. And I met her in a management course. And you know, we kind of talked to each other, we got to know each other. And I guess through the process, I found out that she was struggling through one of her classes. She got an F, which is really bad. And you know, the only way for her to pass the class, I calculated the math for her. And I told her that in order for you to pass your class, you need to get a B+ on the final. And she lost all hope on that because she's like, I got an F. It's like, do you really think I can get a B+ on my final? It's like, and I told her, I was like, yes. I was like, I think you can, and I'm gonna make that happen. So for like that 1 week, I stood like my nights with her, and I told her, like, you know, I encouraged her. I told her everything that she needed to know for the finals. And in the end, about like 2 weeks after our semester ended, she messaged me and she told me that she passed the class. And you know, by helping her pass her class, I have changed the course of her life. So she didn't have to drop. She was actually an honor student for the business administration major. So like she didn't have to drop out of that honors society because, you know, I was able to help her pass. She didn't have to repeat the class. And she was on course to graduate because I was able to help her. And she was so grateful after that, you know, we became very close friends afterwards. And she, every time she sees opportunities, she will come back to me and she'll tell me, it's like, Sylvia, it's like, I found out this opportunity, you know, the ASTE consulting program. I had no idea what it was, but basically it was a really wonderful opportunity when she told me about it. Basically, it was the program that provided you, the students, the opportunity to go out into the communities and really help like real clients, help real businesses kind of like improve them and consult them. So basically like apply the knowledge you learned from school to really impact the community. And it was really amazing. It had a really extensive application process. And I told her, I was like, you know, it's really amazing. This is a really amazing opportunity, but I don't think I have the skills for that. I don't think I'm that talented. But you know, she was very persistent. I mean, she knew I had the talents in me to be successful. So she told me, and she persistently told me to apply for it. It wasn't until the last day of the application day that, you know, she got me to finally like, fine. I was like, I'm gonna apply for it and we'll see, you know, I'm not gonna get it. But, you know, the next day they actually called me for a phone interview and I got the last spot in the program. And through that program, I was able to get into the most difficult project, which was the Logan Heights Community Redevelopment Project. So basically, unlike the other consulting projects, they only have one business client, right? So my consulting project, it had one business client, But the task that the client asked us to do was to go out into the communities and to help like small businesses kind of improve their business.